Leider überzeugt die Musik von Eskimo Callboy nicht. Sie ist nämlich nicht radiotauglich. Deswegen ist Eskimo Callboy nicht dabei.
Ladies and gentlemen and everyone in between, you're right now calling at the bearing the loon. And we are gonna check out the songs in Germany. I can't believe I'm saying it. 12 points. We have the songs for the national selection in Germany ready and lined up to check out right now. And I gotta tell you, I am going in here extremely disappointed. I'll be honest with you. Because here's the thing. Millions of people were looking forward to and hyped about the fact that Eskimo Callboy was going to be participating for Germany in the Eurovision Song Contest. And that's not happening. And we've got some bullshit answers from the awful TV producers. I'm just going to be honest about that. It's extremely bullshit what they have said. The fact that there isn't a spot for Pump It or We Got the Moves, when you've seen the viral global sensations that they are, it is actually unacceptable on many levels. Let's see if this selection right here is so strong and so diverse that it wouldn't have made sense for Eskimo Callboy to join. I will either way go in with an open mind. I usually am very hyped on Germany. I was one of the few people who were having Gendrick as one of my favorites last year, actually. So yeah, I am going into this. Here we go. Here's the first entry. It's called Soap. Check it out.
We used to be so freaking cute, and all the photos we took. Yeah. Honestly, I thought that you were made for me.
Ooh, good progression in the lyrics. I like it. Sounds good.
It's been a day and 7 weeks and 4 years since you left.
You're feeling it in her voice. It sounds kind of lighthearted, but she is not lighthearted. She is her. This is really charming. I really like it. Hey, cool sound effect. I think it's a really creative spin on this topic of love. It's interesting to do it like this. And I think there's a great production here backing what she is doing. And a great punch as well. Really good punch. It is really well written. The lyrics here, they make you want to sing along before you even know them. And I think it's really well done. It isn't necessarily rhymes that are weak. It is rhymes that are done in a very creative and fun manner. And I think she's delivering them really well. She sounds great. The production sounds great. Maybe it's a bit, I wouldn't say basic, but a bit like nothing too special. So it sounds great to listen to. You're familiar with it. But I don't think it will do too well in Eurovision. But it will do well on my playlist because it's really good. I wish something more happened there. Nothing happened. Yeah, I'm not liking this final minute. And let's go to the next one called Anxiety. Okay.
Can't ignore them. I have no choice there.
This is sounding really good.
I'm falling again.
This intro is really, really good. This is building up beautifully. Ooh! She's a creative icon! I like it! Oh fuck! Oh my god! That was so good! Fuck! This is good! Oh my... Sorry, I have to stop! Oh my god! What just happened? What does that mean? So it starts off great with that intro. It's building up beautifully, and you have a great progression and a build-up and all these cool elements. But fuck! Fuck! That was good! I want to hear it again! Fuck! This is so fucking good! This is so fucking... I don't fucking know how to feel! Fuck, okay? Fuck! Fuck! I can't listen to how good this song is! I don't know how to feel. I have you guys experienced that before? When you listen to something that's that fucking good and it's just hitting it? It's hitting the marks. I'm so excited right now. This is so fucking good.
Piece of me that's ever been inside of
me. Fuck, she's that good.
Me, I'm trying my best to get rid of my anxiety.
Oh my god!
Try keeping it inside.
Ooh. I lie about where the voices hide. Oh my fucking god! Oh my fucking god, I love it!
I've got the feeling.
Bravo! Bravo! I don't fucking believe it! I don't fucking believe the song! I feel like I'm listening to like a big hit already. This works on every level. So good. Oh, I even alluded to its outro. Look at that. Look at that. She is a creative icon and she just said with that circle, that's all folks, but it's not all for her career or her journey in the Eurovision Song Contest. That was so brilliant. Oh, this is everything! And here we have the next song. I'm feeling alive right now, Eros.
Long night, lonely road.
A very promising start, but I do feel like I know where it's going.
The one night changed to light. Be
alive. This is so inspirational to listen to, and I bet it will be super fun on stage. Be alive, love being alive. I love the strings in the background. I think the bigger the venue, the better for this song. This isn't a song made for a small stage or a small TV production. This isn't a song made for small shows. This is something made for very big occasions. And I do think that, you know, this is something I'm a huge sucker for these kinds of songs. But I also know that this would flop. But it would be a moment and it would be memorable and it would bring a lot of joy to people to see this at Eurovision. He sounds great and he is a very charismatic performer and he lightens your mood. That was so charming. I really, really enjoyed it. I think this sounded like a summer hit. It sounded also like a radio hit. Hey, we got some Machine Gun Kelly up in here. We're like, I swear to God. Let's see how this goes. It's very clear where they've got their inspiration. We're going in a bit of mid-2000s pop fun. I would follow you in the dark. All over and over again. All over and over again. You know it. I know it. We already know where this song is going. We're feeling this mid-2000s inspirations. We're seeing what they're taking elements from. We're seeing what their sound is. And I think that the drive here is really good. But it is frustrating, to say the least, to say that this is one of the participating entries in that final when you know what's not. And that's upsetting to me, actually. These guys know what they're doing. They have a good sound. I enjoy the song, but I am really disappointed because I've heard hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of songs exactly the same like this, but this lacks that extra thing special. This lacks that moment or this element that makes it stand out. We're going to go over to the next song right now. We're going to go over to a rock star who's going to bring the song Rockstars. Interesting beat in the background. Works really well with the piano. Oh man. He has a great delivery. You feel what he's singing about. There's something about this song, actually. It's promising. Interesting. This is really, really good. It's really interesting how he just switched now to this style of performing his song. It sounds really, really good. I'm really impressed by this. We all set in a place where we look back at better days and wish they weren't so far away. Ooh. Damn! He's spitting facts. Well, damn. Oh, shit. Whoa.
do a restart and be who we are.
This is huge. This is massive. What a performer, what a song. This is beautiful. This is so beautiful. I think we just found the winner. Damn, and time is ticking. Wow. Malik Harris, that was beautiful. What a flow. What a artistic piece of music we just witnessed. He was a great storyteller. These lines were brutal, and he delivered them with such grace. He delivered them so well. He did such a wonderful job. He truly did. That was actually really special. If they actually include the thunder and lightning like they did in this video, they maybe have a stop like the Netherlands did in 2016, where you get time to stand still. There's something about that. It's something about all the emotions you're feeling and then giving you the time to also connect with them, because things are happening so fast in Eurovision. To just get that moment to breathe where nobody talks over, I think it'd be really beautiful. I think this was really, 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 really nice. He did an amazing job. Oh, I feel like this is the perfect song for like a campfire. It's one of those songs you kind of know you will make great memories to. I really enjoy the sound of this. I really, really enjoy how this song is being, you know, progressing here. I really enjoy the style that they're going in. I feel like there's a lot of cool harmonies already happening. Just having a good time and just cruising around. Okay, so does nobody care about the Eurovision rules? Because he can't mention TikTok or Instagram. This is a new dummy promoting FaceTime. Doesn't work. It worked for her, actually. Yeah, I'm really vibing with this song, actually. Really vibing with it. I'm kind of getting the feeling, if you guys have heard the song Numb Little Bug, which got famous from TikTok, it's currently a global hit. And I just wanna see if you feel the same as me. Do you ever get a little bit tired of life? Like you're not really happy, but you don't wanna die. If you slow that down and you just did acoustically, it would feel like this song. Especially that pre-chorus. It just really feels like Numb Little Bug. This is so fucking good, actually. I really enjoy it. Oh, okay. Well, love will come back around, absolutely, because there's so many great songs all over the Eurovision Song Contest. There's so many potential winners also, so it's really fun to listen to. I just said, you know, I'm doing really fine. Like, generally, I'm doing really well. Do you need to let it go? Is this Disney? I don't know, but we don't talk about Bruno. I really, really enjoyed that bridge, even though I was messing around. I really enjoyed it. That's a cool element, actually. Very inclusive, very fun. Maybe a bit more standout now than I originally anticipated. They sound so great together. All of them are working so well. And they're uniting the world. Norway! Woo-hoo-hoo! We look like a penis. And wait, no. Come on. Have you seen Norway? I thought we were friends. I thought we were pals. I really did. Well, anyway, I really enjoyed that song. I think it was a super solid and fun song. Very uplifting. Very, very pleasant to listen to. I do think the one with the most potential in Eurovision would be Rockstars, followed by Anxiety, and then followed by Alive. I do think that's the tree I would think would do well, because I do picture Eros Atomus to do extremely well once it gets on that stage. I will follow this playlist here by Daniel Mayer. Thank you so much for making it, Daniel. Because this right here is a very pleasant selection to listen to. Anxiety and Rockstars has the potential to fight for the left side of the scoreboard, especially Anxiety. I do feel like there's something very special about that song. But yeah, Let me know what you think. And as always, have a great day, a great life. And please remember to take care of yourself and each other. Take care.